Good morning, class. Today is Tuesday, June 16, 2020. Today we're looking at test prep questions, which involve the unit, the history of planet Earth. In this unit, we talk about plate tectonics. We talk about weathering and erosion, and basically all the how fossils help us prove or give us clues of the past. Okay, proof theories. So I want you guys to first click on this link. This link is going to take you to a place where you can quickly review. It's not too in-depth, so I think that's beneficial for you guys. You don't have to spend too much time on it. We have fossils here. So these fossils are going to show us little clues of the past, and scientists help study these fossils to understand what were the organisms that lived on Earth 300 million years ago, or even a billion years ago, if there was any life. So fossils are very crucial for us to understand the past. After this, you're going to have 6 questions. Five questions, okay? So I want you, before to engage in these questions, I want you to look at this PowerPoint. If it doesn't open the PowerPoint, I might have to send it to you on email. This PowerPoint briefly goes about everything we just talked about. If you want to recap, remember, we have different types of rocks. We have 3 types of rocks: sedimentary rocks, which are formed through compaction and compaction of sediments. And this is the only type of rock where you will have fossils. The other rocks are metamorphic, is caused by heat and pressure. And igneous rocks are caused by volcanic lava that hardens. Okay? So if you wanted a quick review, there's your quick review. Remember, sedimentary rock is the only type of rock that it has fossils. I like to ask why, because usually I always ask why in my test. The reason being is because metamorphic, the heat and pressure will obliterate or destroy the rock, and igneous rock is lava, so lava cannot hold any fossils. Okay, so if you wanted to look at these, this basically explains weathering and erosion as well. Remember, weathering is when the rock is exposed to wind, water, air, etc., plants, ice, and erosion. Erosion is basically a process that occurs over time as rocks begin to break down due to the movement of water, the movement of wind. I mean, there's many things. Okay, so you can look at this review if you wish. Let's go back over here. And then on top of that, I have a quick, I think I might have put the wrong document, but don't worry, I'll fix that for you guys. It should have been this one. I put the wrong document. Okay, we'll go back and fix that. So if Earth Science Review Sheet, I gotta give you the other one. Okay, I put the wrong document, but don't worry about that. That's the least of our worries. I want to go over to the questions. So you got question number 2. It says the inference that Earth's interior has an outer core and an inner core is based on studies of. How do we know the inner and outer core of Earth? Basically, this is what the question is asking you. Let's look at the Earth's structure. How do we know what's the inside of Earth like? So this is a good picture. If we look at this picture right here, how do we know the inner and outer core of the Earth? So let's go back. What would you say? Earthquake data? Glaciers? Would a glacier tell us the inside of the Earth? Recent fossil discoveries? Do you think the fossils would tell us how the structure of the Earth is inside? Or last one, celestial observations. Celestial observations is basically space. Anything having to do with the stars, outer space. So I want you to think about this one. There's only one right answer, and there's one that's going to be very, straight to the point. You have to think about this one's a little tricky. All right, next question. And then we have, where's number 29? 29 doesn't come up. Technical difficulties is always happening. So 29. Earth's surface has a relative thin solid outer shell called the, I can't tell you that one, guys. You should know this from the test. All right. And this is a weathering I think I might have gave it away. But if you were paying attention to this video thus far, I think you deserve that extra point. All right. So I want you guys to look at these questions. If there's any questions that you have on these specific test questions, you can write it on the comment box.